So here's the question that was posed to us. Is an elephant actually worth $1.6 million over its lifetime? Now, this question needs a phenomenal amount of context. So let's go back to the original report. The original report was done in 2014 by the David Sheldrick Wildlife Trust. That's a wildlife trust in Kenya that looks after orphaned, typically orphaned elephants, but takes in all sorts of orphaned wildlife. Phenomenal organization. They do such amazing work. As you can imagine, when the report got released in 2014, it got picked up by a lot of different news outlets. You can just Google 1.6 million elephant value and all of it will come up in Google. Even Scientific American picked it up. But the intent of the report in 2014 was to show, because of the rampant poaching that was occurring, that an elephant alive is worth more than an elephant dead in a poaching context. The report in 2014 was based on the first 8 months of data collected by the seizures of illegal ivory, and they took the tonnage of ivory that they had collected over the 43 different shipments and calculated what that actual ivory was worth on the black market. It came out to like $44 million. In the report itself, it starts to mention this $23,000/$21,000 number per elephant per year number that then gets extrapolated to just over $1.6 million per elephant over its lifetime in terms of its value on the landscape. There is a single statement in that report, and I want to read it verbatim. By comparison, the estimated tourism value of a single living elephant is 1.607624 over its lifetime to travel companies, airlines, and local economies. Unfortunately, there's no source to how they calculated that number. In the footnote, in the sources of this page, it says, 1994, Curry D, Moore D, and EIA, African elephants, the success of CITES Appendix 1 ban, Curry and Moore gave a figure of 1 million that is adjusted for inflation. So I'm assuming the 1.6 is adjusted for inflation. Unfortunately, this is where things have gone off the rails, and we're seeing this more and more often. The original report and its intent and the number in that original report are being hijacked. Unfortunately, now it's being used as a weapon against sustainable consumptive use, in which the intent of the report was never meant to do that. It was solely against poaching. Secondly, which I think is the biggest issue, is the $1.6 million number. Nowadays, that $1.6 million is used everywhere and is spoken as absolute gospel truth. Where in fact, there's no science, there's no paper, there's no description of how the 1.6 million was actually generated. It took me all but 30 minutes of a rabbit hole or a couple of rabbit hole searches on Google to figure out that I could not come up with the number. I couldn't come up with the methodology. I couldn't come up with how it got derived. I couldn't figure out how the $23,000 per year per elephant generated that $1.6 million number. Now, I might have missed it. And if I did miss it, let me know. Send me the article. Send me the source. Send me the citation. And I will state on camera that I was wrong. So here are a couple more truths. Can a single elephant, like a Craig in Amboseli, a big elephant in Monopoles, a big elephant in Kruger, can that single elephant generate more than 1.6 million in tourism in its lifetime? The answer is probably yes. But can every single elephant on the African continent generate $1.6 million in its lifetime? The answer is unequivocally no. And if it was true, then we wouldn't see national parks in financial troubles. There are many, many national parks across the entire continent of Africa that are not financially viable, even though they have elephants. The number was generated in light of the most devastating period of poaching that Africa had seen in a long, long, long time. Every elephant is not worth 1.6 million for tourism. Nicolas Bichel stated it absolutely perfectly when he said, tourists are not paying 10 times more to see 50 elephants than 5 elephants. They're paying the same to see one or 1,000. I just added that last bit, Nikolai. The initial report has now created something that it never intended to do, which was to put up photographic tourism against consumptive use tourism and bastardize consumptive use tourism as the evil stepchild. That was never the intent of the report. Nor should our communications ever say that photographic and consumptive use tourism are at odds. They are in harmony, because if they are both doing the right thing for the right reason, they are doing it for the intent and purpose of conserving wildlife for the future. End of story. So are elephants worth $1.6 million? There's my answer.